In this video, I'm going to show you how to cut a hexagon first from a square sheet of paper, and then how to cut a hexagon from a rectangular sheet of paper. Office paper will work very well. For example, letter, which is used in Canada and the US, or A4, which is used in most other parts of the world. We're going to start by aligning two opposite edges and making a horizontal crease. And unfold. Then rotate and again align the two edges and make a crease. Unfold and bring the lower edge to the crease you just created to crease a quarter. Unfold and then refold the crease in the center. Now take this point up here and make a crease that starts in that lower left point so that the point up there lies exactly on that horizontal crease. And I'm going to turn the paper just to make it easier to fold, because I find it much easier to fold away from me rather than to me. So start a crease in that point and then align this point with the crease that's on a quarter of the original square, like so. Do the same thing on the other side. Notice how I'm only folding one layer, and that's just because if you fold two layers, usually the second crease won't be as accurate. So now we're going to turn over the paper and then make the same creases just by aligning these edges, like creating an edge that aligns with that one. And making a crease. Same thing on the other side. It really pays off to work accurately here. Then turn over the model again and unfold those flaps on both sides. Now we need to determine how much of this area we need to fold down to get a nice hexagon. So we're going to start a crease in this point right here and align that point again with that quarter crease, basically doing the mirror image of what we did before. So I'm again going to turn the paper around just because I want to fold away from myself, and then first pinch right here to get nice precision. Just make a small pinch and then just move the paper until that crease right in the center, until it aligns with the center crease. And then you only need to make a crease right in the top so that you get the intersection of that crease that you can see over there. And then do the same thing on the other side. Just first pinching to get a nice accuracy right here in the bottom, and then moving the paper until those creases align, and then just pinch in the top. Unfold, and now we're going to make a crease that connects these two intersections. And then our hexagon will be done. It's the first one and the second one, like so. Again, I'm only folding one layer to get better precision, and then turning the model around to fold the other side. Like so. Then unfold everything, and you will be able to see that you have a hexagon on your square which you can then cut. If you have a rectangular piece of paper, for example office paper, like A4 or letter, then you can also make a hexagon, and I'll show you how. First, fold edge to edge, aligning the long edges with each other. Unfold, and then bring the lower edge to the center to crease a quarter. Then rotate, and again bring the lower edge to the central crease to crease a quarter. Now unfold, and now we want to make a 60 degree angle right here, so we're going to take this lower point, start a crease in this point, and that lower point is going to be aligned with that quarter crease. So again, I'm just rotating the paper to fold away from myself, pinching to get nice accuracy there, and then moving the paper so that this point lies on that quarter crease, like so. Same thing on the other side. Pinch to get nice accuracy, and then align the point with the quarter crease. Unfold, and now take this lower edge and align it with the crease you just created. This will make a crease that is in a 60 degree angle to that crease, like so. Try to make this nice and accurate, and then crease. Unfold, and then do the same thing on the other side, making another crease in a 60 degree angle, like so, and unfold. Now we have almost a whole hexagon here already. We only need to finish this side. So again, we need creases in a 60 degree angle. So align this edge with the crease you just created. Unfold and repeat on the other side. Unfold, and then you can see your hexagon right here. The creases that you have on the hexagon aren't too bad because they connect points and quarter this distance. When you work on a square, there's a crease that you probably don't like. In any case, if you want a hexagon with any additional creases on this area, you can try just pinching so that you get the intersections to make landmarks, or just make a stencil out of some cardboard and then use that to mark it on a sheet of paper and then cut it. Of course, the stencil will only work for one size. Now, all you need to do is take a cutting mat and then cut away the excess paper. There's one hexagon. And there's your second one. helps in making hexagons from squares and rectangular sheets of paper.